Welcome to another video from Beta CAE Systems. In this video, the new inherit functionality will be presented, demonstrating how different design versions of a part can be treated in ANSA version 23. Starting from a solid description of a casting part, the middle surface mesh has been extracted using the casting functionality of ANSA. The result has been corrected and improved, and it is ready to be solved. In many cases, a newer design version of the same part can arise, which might have some design changes or some other differences when compared to the older version. In order to identify and locate these differences, the Compare tool of ANSA can be used. Opening the Compare tool, the older version of the model is selected to be compared with the current model. Since the model is intended to be used for the extraction of its middle surface mesh, a casting comparison scenario is selected. Once the compare is finished, the two models open next to each other on two different windows. On the Compare tool window, the tolerances of the comparison can be set. Going to the navigation mode, the models are laid on top of each other on a third window, and the faces that were recognized as different are colored. The faces that are different on the newer version can be seen here with a red color. This includes a flange that got longer and holes were open to it, a rib that is straight in the newer design version, and features that were either moved or completely removed from the part. As it was made clear from the comparison, besides some feature changes, the parts were mostly similar. So when it comes to the extraction of the middle surface mesh, ANSA gives the opportunity to avoid doing the same work twice for the areas that are common between design versions, by inheriting the middle mesh as it is from a part that is already prepared. All the tools necessary for the extraction of the middle surface can be found under the middle mesh menu layout. In the middle mesh auto-generate window, the casting parameters are set on the first tab. It is also in this tab where the option to inherit a mesh from a different design version can be selected. In the Features tab, 2D holes recognition is available, and specific treatment can be set depending on the hole size. Hitting OK and the function starts running. After the casting finishes, the result is an FE cell mesh at the middle position of the initial solid description. Since the inherit functionality was used, only the areas that were different between the two parts were newly generated. In all the other areas that were common, the mesh was inherited completely unchanged from the already prepared design version. These areas are colored blue in the result in order to be identified and excluded from the inspection of the middle mesh result from the user. Proceeding with the improvement of the result in the newly generated areas, the new direct edit functionality comes in use. The new holes were generated with the correct align definition and treatment, and the flange was extended to its new length. This area can be now excluded from further inspection from the right mouse click menu. The excluded areas can be massively edited by right-clicking on the legend and using the box selection. Moving to the central area, the drag and drop action can be used to add perimeters to the correct align definition. With the shortcut key B, the improvement brush comes up and the reconstruct can be locally applied where needed. Changing to the Elements Edit mode with the Q key, some triads can be dragged and removed from the mesh. By right-clicking on a perimeter, an imprint align constraint can be set. Using the drag and drop action again, the rest of the perimeters are added to the correct align definition. The number of nodes on a perimeter can be decreased or increased using the keys 1 and 2 from the keyboard. Empty perimeters are aligned to the correct faces. A local reconstruct is again applied using the brush to get a better mesh result. This feature here has been generated from scratch and connected to the rest of the part, and only some align constraint corrections are needed. In a spot where the fillet was not represented successfully, a perimeter is manually created and imprinted from the geometry definition. The align constraint of this area is easily edited from the right mouse click menu. The improved brush is used once more. In the area where a feature used to be and has been removed completely in this design version, some perimeters were left and need to be removed from the final result. Finally, some trial elements are eliminated easily with the direct functionality. The smooth is applied using the improved brush to get a nice mesh quality. Before finishing, a check needs to be executed for cracks and gaps in the cell mesh. The check recognizes any potential cracks in the model and provides an automated fix. To check the accuracy of the result, the inspect function is available. The inspect will compare the result to the initial geometry and mark the areas that need correction, based on the values given in the options list. Select the whole model and hit middle mouse button to run. Any misplaced area will be colored according to the error type. On the legend, the coloring scheme is described and the visibility of the results can be turned on and off. After correcting the result in the areas that is needed, when the visibility of the inspect is turned on again, the results get updated. If any correction occurs while the visibility is on, the results get automatically updated on the moment. When all errors are fixed, the model of the new design version is ready after putting the effort only on fixing areas that were different from work that has already been done. Thank you very much for watching this video.